Bang Bong, John Nutt, Fox Sports Asia, Full Metal Dojo. It's all happening here live from Bangkok. Today was a heck of a Sunday morning with the two big boys, the promotions, Bellator and the UFC. Everybody knows about the UFC, but Asians get down with the Bellator. They've got a tournament on. First things first, though, Daniel Cormier is still the light heavyweight champion of the world with an amazing victory over Volkan. Man, Daniel Cormier, DC, needs to get more love, needs to get more respect. Not only is he with the Fox Sports family, so he does his pundit work, if you will, he probably is one of the most badass human beings on the planet. Mark it, make it known. DC, Daniel Cormier, staying alive. He brought up Jon Jones at post-fight interview, but I don't think it matters. He also brought up Cain Velasquez will be back in that heavyweight division. Why do I say that? Why do I make that important? Why do we need to take note? Because in the heavyweight division, Francis Ngannou stepped up. This man, absolute manimal. 8 months of training, just the whole total package of the man from Cameroon. Donald Trump calling him a shithole country. He fought a man from a shithole city. That's right. Cleveland, your football team is the color of fecal matter. And I am telling you what, Stipe, he doesn't care. Because Stipe, oh, mio chick, fought fires the week before. Fought fires the week before, has been telling people that he doesn't want to be famous, been telling people that he wants out of the limelight. Try to stay out of the TMZ limelight, that is Fox Sports Asia, because I will tell you what, Stipe, you're the man. Heavyweight champion, proving that he's the heavyweight champion for a reason. The fight literally looked like experience versus non-experience. Got the shots, got the takedowns, laid on him, put the arm across the grill, put the arm across the throat, made all of his magic happen. And still, and that's what UFC 220 live from Boston was all about. And still. And we move over to Bellator. Why Bellator? Not only was it going on just right against the UFC head-to-head, so kudos for you guys for doing that, but we started off the heavyweight championship tournament with Chael Sonnen versus Rampage Jackson. Everybody's saying Rampage, coming in at 265, looking huge. Jaw from like Hades, hell. Jaw from hell. But Chael Sonnen picked up that victory via a unanimous decision, held him down, so kudos to Chael. Elsewhere on that card, Douglas Lima suffered an L to Rory McDonald. Rory McDonald still shooting the path of being one of the best welterweights in the world that's not in the UFC. What people also need to take note on, Paul Semtex Daly says he was discouraged by all the love Michael Venom Page is getting in the mixed martial arts world, especially on Bellator. He's saying that he wants to fight out his contract and move elsewhere. Can you imagine Paul Semtex Daly, the man that Dana White said would never get another fight in the UFC? It's been a couple years, and Dana's changed his tune a couple times. I, for one, would love to see Paul Semtex Daly in the welterweight division of the UFC. Either way, today was a fantastic day for combat sports. From John Nutt, everybody at Fox Sports Asia, stay moist.